Hey guys, welcome back to our channel. It's currently 8:41 right now. Colson is wrapping up eating his breakfast. I gave him blended blueberries and Greek yogurt, so he ate a good amount of it, but now he's literally just making a complete mess. But I thought I would start today's video off sharing with you guys my night. I am exhausted to say the least. I woke up so many times last night, but I guess I didn't realize how many times until I just looked at our baby monitor. So we put him to bed at 9:55. We were at my in-laws' house, so he fell asleep around 7 there. When we got back, I fed him a bottle because I just wanted to fill him up more to try to get longer stretches, because he's been sleeping through the night ever since 2 months, but once he got RSV around 6 months, he has not slept through the night, maybe 3 times, if that. But other than that, he's woken up a lot, and last night I feel like might have been the worst night ever. He fell asleep at 9:50. He woke up again at, bless you, he woke up again at 10:50, then woke up again at 11:52, and then woke up again at 12:15, where I literally put a pillow and blanket on the floor because I was contemplating literally sleeping next to him because I'm just so exhausted getting up from my bed, walking across the house just to put a pacifier back into his mouth, because I'm not going in there and like picking him up and soothing him to back to sleep. I'm literally just going in there and putting his pacifier back in and walking back to bed. And then he woke up again at 3:35, woke up again at 4:56, woke up again at 5:11, woke up again at 6:12, and woke up again for the last time at 6:38, and then he just stayed in his crib until I got up at 7 o'clock, because I just wanted to just lay in bed, even though I wasn't able to fall back to sleep because I just hear him blabbing and crying. So it was a very long night, and this coffee was much needed. I feel like I'm getting sick. My throat, I feel like, is very scratchy, and I don't know if it's from the lack of sleep that I've had in the past month or the change of weather, because my body just doesn't agree with Florida weather being cold half the week and blazing hot the other half of the week. So it's just been a day, and I just thought I would bring you guys along. I'm going to clean him off now, get him ready for his nap at 9 o'clock. Let's have a good Monday. Yes, I'm the slowest drinker when it comes to coffee in the world. It is 10 o'clock right now, and I made this, I believe, at like 8 o'clock. But I think I found out why Colson is so fussy today. Yes, I've already had 2 breakdowns, but after showering and getting myself ready for the day, I feel so much better. So I totally forgot about Leaps, and I have the Wonder Weeks app. It says that today he's currently in the lightning stage, which means he's currently going through Leap, which is Leap 6. It's the fussy stage, which totally explains it. And it says we have 23 days left, so we will see how that goes. But while I was getting ready, I was doing a TikTok, and I was talking about how I thought the stay-at-home mom life just wasn't for me. And I started that TikTok like 4 days ago, and I'm really happy that I didn't post it. I was with some of my friends that are moms this weekend, and I was just expressing to them like how I feel with me being a stay-at-home mom now that I was laid off from my job. And honestly, it just felt so good that I was able to relate to them. And yeah, it sucks that all of us agreed that being a mom, like, you lose yourself. But like I said, I just feel like that just comes with being a mom. That's something that you're going to overcome. And I stopped going to the gym whenever I got laid off my job just to save some money. And I'm really, really mad at myself for doing that, because it was something that I did for myself every single day before Colson got up. I literally got up at 5 a.m. every single day, went to the gym, got home, showered, ate breakfast, all before 7 a.m. And that just made me feel so good about myself. Nowadays, I'm literally waking up at 7 a.m. whenever he wakes up. I have to shower quickly and get myself ready while he's doing his first nap of the day. I just love that 5 a.m. routine, and I really want to get myself back into it really, really bad. But going back to what I was talking about with my friends, like, one of the girls said, one thing that I do for myself every single month, I go and get my nails done. Like, that makes me feel so good about myself. That makes me feel confident. And the other one said the same thing when it comes to working out. Like, she started going back to Orange Theory because that's what made her so happy. So I don't know, just having that conversation just made me feel so seen. And on Saturday, my friend works at a med spa, and she needed a model to do lash lifting. And I'm not gonna lie, just being gone for an hour to, what, 3 hours, just by myself, without my husband, without my kid, I came back feeling just so refreshed and renewed. I was very, very moody towards Dustin before I left. And when I came back, I was all smiles, so happy. And that just shows just doing something for yourself, no matter what it is, will make you feel so good. So if you're stepping into motherhood, just make sure you're still doing something for yourself. I just went through my planner, just kind of planned my day and what I needed to do today. You want to go in the car? Probably not. Okay, it's 11:40 right now. Colson is about to fall asleep any minute and I'm off to do some errands. So I have to go to UPS to drop off our package. I have to go to the car wash to wash the inside and outside of the car. And then I have to go to K's because I need to get my right hand middle finger and pointer finger sized. I want to get myself a breast milk ring. I just finished the last bag of our freezer stash. I'm actually really sad about it and I don't think I'll be pumping or breastfeeding for my next baby because it was really, really exhausting, but also I'm very proud of myself for the journey. So I went on Etsy and found a ring that I really like and I saved a few ounces, so I'll be able to ship that to them and they'll make the ring out of my breast milk. So I'm super excited about that. I just need my ring sizes because I just have no idea what any of my fingers are sized at except for my ring finger. And then I'll probably just end all these errands by going to different stores because I just want to get out of the house. So I'll be walking Target and all the different plazas that have like Ulta, Ross, and everything like that. So let's go. Okay, we just got to UPS and there's just one thing that all UPS stores need to have. It's a drive-through for all of your drop-offs that's like small, because I have a kid sleeping in the back right now and now I have to take him out of the car seat or just take the car seat out of the car and go over there, and he's probably gonna wake up and I really don't want him to because he literally just got done having a screaming fest, and I just don't understand how that's possible because he was sleeping through the whole time I was vacuuming this car, and right when I drove off then he started to cry. It is currently 2:12 right now. We just got back from running errands. Colson fell asleep on the way home, so I was trying to transfer him to his crib. But of course, once I put him down, he immediately woke up. And it's not even his nap time, but I was gonna try to let him rest because he isn't feeling the best. But no, he wanted to just hang out a little bit longer. But I went to Ulta. I got myself my hyaluronic acid and my niacinamide. These are like my main skincare staples. But other than that, we are home for the rest of the day. I have to go online and order the breast milk ring. I got my finger sizes. It's a 6.5 and a 6. So I think I'm just gonna get a 6.5, which it makes me nervous because I feel like every type of ring kind of fits my finger differently. I feel like the shape of the band affects it a lot. So a part of me does want to get a size 6 just so I know that it will fit on this finger and possibly maybe even like one of my left hand fingers, but I don't know. First, I'm going to make myself some lunch. I haven't eaten anything, go figure. And then I will go and do some computer work. So it's currently 3:57 right now. Colson usually goes down for his last nap of the day at 3 o'clock, but since he napped a little bit in his last wake window, he just now started to get fussy. So he'll probably sleep for about 30-ish minutes. And usually I wouldn't even want him to sleep longer than 5 o'clock because then he won't go down at 7 p.m. when he usually does. But I was able to buy my breast milk ring. They actually only had like full sizes available. So they only had a size 6 and not any half sizes. So I got the size 6 and now I have to print out like the shipping information and ship my breast milk. So that'll probably be another day this week that I actually go to the post office and send that. But I'm super excited to have that done. But now that I'm looking at my agenda, Colson starts swim next week, literally next Monday on the 13th. So I have to make sure that he has everything for that. Basically the right bathing suit, I guess. I have like a full body suit for him. I think I remember reading that he needed to have like swim diapers and that's it. So I just have to make sure that I have the correct size for him because I know that I have, I believe, a 12 month or 18 month, but I do have another size, but I don't know what that is. So I just need to make sure that if I don't have it, that I Amazon Prime it to make sure that it's here in time.
Oh.
Hey guys, so it is currently actually exactly 6 o'clock. Colson just got done eating, and I don't know if you guys can see from there, but he is a complete mess. I always let him play with his food after, just so he can kind of feel comfortable with the textures of all the foods and everything like that. I just did rice cereal and then mixed in blended asparagus. And this is the first time that he's had asparagus, and I think it might be his favorite vegetable. He literally did not make any like sour face or grossed out face. But yeah, so I'm gonna get him out of the seat because I don't want him to be irritated or annoyed while sitting in the high chair. And since he's already a mess, I'm gonna bring him into the bath to start our night routine. So it's currently 6:35 right now, around there. So we had a pretty long bath. We were basically in the bath for 30 minutes. I called my parents, FaceTimed them so they're able to see him for a little bit. And that was actually the first time that I had him just laying in the actual bathtub, and he absolutely loved it. Like, I have so many videos of him that I can't really show because it shows his whole body, but he was literally just like bouncing off the walls and sliding and just like splashing. It was just literally so cute to see. But he starts swim next week, like I mentioned earlier, and I just saw that that was a way to get him even more used to the water. And he's always liked the water, so I just feel like that was a way to also tire him out, wind him down for the night, and also get used to the water. So I'm going to continue to do that. I actually liked it, and it was very, very entertaining. But Colson is in his breakfast pajamas, and I'll probably feed him his last bottle at 7. Usually I feed it to him now or around like 6:45, but I just feel like we just got done eating his dinner at 6, so I'm gonna wait a little bit. So I'll probably just put him down on his gather mat right here and let him play a little bit longer with all the puzzles that he has down there, and read him a book, and then lay him down. Okay, it's currently 7:04. Colson probably fell asleep maybe 5-ish minutes ago. He fell asleep on the bottle with like less than a quarter ounce left. So I'm sure he's gonna wake up, because he usually does if he does fall asleep on the bottle. But usually once Colson is down for the night, I finish anything that I really need to get done around the house. I eat if we haven't eaten dinner yet. And then I change on my clothes and just relax, either watch TV or even read for the rest of the night. I think I'm going to end the video here. Thank you guys so much for watching today's video. If you guys are not yet subscribed, make sure you guys hit that subscribe button. But I'm gonna go enjoy the rest of my night and wait until Dustin gets home from basketball. So I will talk to you guys later. Bye.